Hi everyone, this is Anne. Ladies, yesterday I made this cut-up card and some of you guys asked me for a tutorial. So today I'm going to share with you how to make it. It's really quick and easy and you can make lots of this for holidays or birthday, you know, your kid's birthday or invitations, things like that because it's cute and it doesn't take much time and paper, you know, you save paper too. So I made this one last night and I used Forever Friend stamp, really cute, and I just colored it in with Copic markers, cut out a square, you know, a diamond shape like this, and I punched the corners with my Stuart Corner punch, and I added some glitters and used liquid pearls and punch out butterflies to decorate the front of my belly band here. And when you open it up, it looks like this, similar to the one that I made yesterday. But this one will go to my girlfriend, so I jazz it up a little bit with corner punch, you know, just look prettier. And I just used some butterflies and things like that. So this is the card that I'm going to show you how to make. And it's actually a little bit different from the one that I made yesterday, because yesterday was the first time that I tried this card. And I wasted paper, guys, so I came up with a new dimension. And this way you can use the 12x12 cardstock, you know, and you can actually make three cards from a piece of 12x12. So let's get started. So first thing you need a piece of cardstock. Cut it at 4.5x12 inches long. So this is the dimension for the cardstock. 12 inches long by 4.5 inches tall, and then you're gonna score at 2 inches, 4 inches, 8 inches, and 10 inches. I already scored mine, and you will fold it in and out just like this, in and out, so it will open up like a shutter card, like this, really quick and easy, and just crease it well. Then we set it aside. Now you need some pattern paper, and for these cards, you know, it's so much fun. You can mix and match pattern paper and you can use like scraps that you have and it will come out really pretty. So what you need is 4 pieces of these pattern paper, same size. So I wrote the dimension here. So first piece will go inside so you can write your message, and the big one is 3¾ by 4¼ inches. This one, and then you will need 4 pieces of this size, 1¾ by 4¼, so 3 of that. And for the belly band, you can use either cardstock or pattern paper. The last one that I made, last two, I used pattern paper, but this one I used cardstock, and I actually use some washi tape in the middle here just to make it look a little prettier. And for the belly band, for this side of card, it's 1¾ by 10 inches long, and I use edge punch to decorate both edges. And this one is the Fisker scallop punch. You can use any edge punch that you have. So that's that. And then what you need to do, I like to round the corner of my card. I mean the corners of my card. And I use the corner chomper, the 1/2 inch corner, and you just punch out 4 corners here, routed all 4 corners of the entire card. So it will look like this now. And then you just figure out where you want your pattern paper to go. I want mine to look like this on the outside, so now I'm gonna punch corners of these pattern paper, and again I use the 1/2 inch corner. So that's that, and same for the inside. So inside, this one will look like this, so I have to punch the right corners. And another one on the left here. And you can kind of assemble this. just like that. And then for this one, I'm gonna use the butterfly corner punch. And I will punch four corners. I try not to cough, guys, because if I start, I couldn't stop. Oh, I cough so much. And I hope I get better before this Monday, because I want to go back to work. Well, anyway, then I'm going to use some distress ink on this pattern paper. And I'm going to use the scatter straw here. So now we're going to glue all the pieces down. And then what we're gonna do, we're gonna make a belly band. So again, this is, I cut this at 1¾ by 10 inches long. And I like to make it a little loose, you know, I don't want the band to be too tight around my card because it's gonna be difficult to slip it in. You can even make it shorter than this because you can see that, you know, you have some parts that overlap like this. So it will go in and out like that. So once you get the right size for your band, just put some glue. And glue it down. Just like this. And now we will decorate the front. And let's see, I have these stamp again that I showed you yesterday. I want to try to use the cupcake here. So I'm going to use this one and this one. So, and I will stamp it on pattern paper and cut it out. So I will go on top of it like this. It's really cute. So let's put some glue over here. Look at that. Isn't it cute? I love it. It's so adorable. So super cute. So now I'm going to put it on top of my belly band, but I'm going to punch out some scallop circle and layer that cupcake on top of it. So I'm going to use this punch here And let's see if I have any scrap of paper left. Maybe I will use this one because I love the bright colors. Okay. And I will use dimensional adhesive behind the cake here. Oh, it's gonna rain and I have to go out and pick up something. Oh, well. Maybe I put two on top of one another. I want it to raise up a little bit more. So it will look like this. Okay, I think it looks really cute here. I love it. Okay. Then put it in the middle. Just insert it in. And that's that. See, you get a really cute card. I totally love it. I'm gonna decorate it some more and I'll show you the finished product. So here is my finished card. I decorated it some more with the punch out flowers. I'm using these hydrangea punch and I just punch out pattern paper and, you know, added diamond stickles and liquid pearls for flower center. I think I missed one tiny dot here. We'll just add it real quick, so just like that, and I just glue it on the cupcake and the belly band, and you can see it's glittery on the cup there because I added the diamond stickles. And over here I stamped make a wish, and then I drew tiny dotted lines, you know, all over these panel here. I'm using liquid pearls and I love to do this. I think it adds really nice texture to the pattern paper, you know. Looks really cute like that. And then inside, I just keep it simple. I stamp happy birthday to you using this stamp set that I got like years ago, guys. Maybe like a few years back. And it's from Martha Stewart. I think it's really cute. All of the stamps here are really pretty. So I just did that. And that's that. That's the card. It's very quick and easy to make, guys. I hope you try it. And if you do, let me know. And also, I hope you like my tutorial. Let me know what you think, and I'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.